High energy bills, uncomfortable rooms, and ice dams? You know it's time to upgrade that attic insulation, but what are your best options? Hi, I'm Tom McTaggart, an estimator with RetroFoam of Michigan. Let's discuss and compare the most common types of attic insulation, including fiberglass, cellulose, and spray foam. Cellulose can be either loose fill or blown-in material made from recycled denim or newspaper. Cellulose can be installed by a professional or done as a do-it-yourself project. Just rent the machine and buy the material at your local home improvement store. Over time, cellulose can settle up to 20%, can shift to one side of the attic, and it won't create an air seal. This is the primary cause of high energy bills and other problems. If old cellulose is currently in the attic, adding more inches may increase its effectiveness over the short run. The other option would be to remove the cellulose completely and re-insulate with an air seal material to maximize energy efficiency. More on that in a second. Fiberglass can be used in all areas of the home. It is made from extremely fine glass fibers, and it can be used in rolls or loose fill. Fiberglass is made to be placed between floor joists, and it is the least expensive insulation material for the attic. However, it also allows for major airflow, leading to potential comfort and energy efficiency problems. Old, dirty, and ineffective fiberglass can be removed from the attic and replaced with new insulation. The ideal option would be to first air seal all the gaps and cracks before installing the fiberglass. But this extra step adds major expense and time to the project. Spray foam is made of organic chemical compounds obtained from petroleum extracts. It can be used to air seal and insulate most areas of the home. Spray foam is further divided into open cell and closed cell foam insulation, but open cell is most often used in the home due to its high expansion to fill all the gaps and cracks. Foam insulation not only insulates, but is an air barrier material that reduces energy bills and adds comfort. Because of its superior benefits, it is the most effective option for solving insulation-related problems in the home, but comes with the highest initial cost. Over time, the total investment is actually much less than other insulation materials, as it lasts the lifetime of the home and provides monthly savings on energy bills. Old insulation from the attic would need to be removed before spray foam is applied. Most contractors will do this dirty work as well as dispose of the old insulation. So, which insulation type is best for your attic? It's really up to you to decide. If you're looking for the short-term, cheaper option, adding some traditional insulation is the best way to go. However, if you're looking for a long-term, energy-efficient option, spray foam is the best option. Thanks for watching. Head on over to our Learning Center to learn more about our attic insulation.